Now this one here. Now remember, a while ago, you wore the outside of the cow, the inside of the cow. Now this would be the outside of the cow. This is the leather here.
I'm ignoring you.
Oh, all right. Well, tell me about this one. Tell me about this one.
This is also Terry Mugler.
Okay.
Actually, it was inspired by humanoids, alien sex humanoid hybrid woman.
My favorite. Now this is, now you do something that women.
Actually, it was inspired by humanoids, alien sex humanoid hybrid woman.
You look beautiful.
Thank you so much.
You look beautiful.
Thank you so much.
And yet you have a wonderful outfit. You put so much time and effort in it. You know what? I think you're really great. People get here early and you look great and you have wonderful taste and everything. I thought you were just fantastic. Thank you so much.
A group gathering here in Washington to talk about their UFO sightings.
Have extraterrestrials visit us here on Earth?
Well, you are looking at what could be a UFO. More unexplained lights over Stephenville. Is this some military secret or a visitor from space?
Is if one of these craft came down on Earth and did an interview with one of us, the debate would be over. But that hasn't happened yet.
Hasn't happened yet, but there's, you know, who knows? Because, you know, who knows? Because, you know, who knows?
Hi everybody, this is YAHUSHUA 777 representing a mighty wind ministry, mightywind.com, for the praise, glory, and honor of my Heavenly Father, Yahweh, YAHUSHUA, His Son, my Savior, and the precious Holy Spirit. Now what are we going to talk about today? We're going to talk about aliens. For real? Going to talk about demons. Going to talk about the blue beam rapture. Things of that nature we're going to talk about. And why? Because you need to know these things so you will not be deceived. Many of you out there know that we have been battling a satanic network of covens for a long time now. People masquerading as Christians, but that are really serving the devil. Why are they here? To put a sleeper hold on the Christian community, choking the life out of them, choking the anointing out of them, and so much that they will become more and more like themselves, vile, lying hypocrites that are being conformed daily into the image of the Father, the devil. All right? People that compromise, hypocrites, backstabbers, liars, betrayers, people that just like the Father, the devil did, for 40 days in the wilderness when he tried to tempt YAHUSHUA, the Son of God, misquoting the Bible, using it for their own purposes, to try to persecute and chase off the genuine and insert the false one. A false, counterfeit anointing and spirit, a demon that they call the Holy Spirit. Okay? So what you've got here in the Christian community running rampant is a rock and roll, new age, anything goes, carnal Christianity of compromise. And anybody that speaks out against sin is called a hater. You're not supposed to speak about God's wrath and judgment on sin and the great tribulation coming up and Satan's schemes and plans, because if you do that, you're simply not positive. You are a hater and a bad example. And you judge people. That's how that goes, okay? But this satanic network of covens has also chosen to mock this ministry for the fact that God Almighty had so much love for this generation that he raised up a prophet through which he has prophesied a coming alien invasion. They say it's not biblical. Oh, really? I am sure that those that have a loving, obedient relationship with YAHUSHUA, and those that don't have it at this time but will have it because they will be touched by the Holy Spirit, and that are sincerely seeking for the truth, After this video, I know without a shadow of a doubt, they will run from these people and they will hide this knowledge and the truth in their hearts, that it might preserve their lives and their souls in these last days leading up to the Great Tribulation. And there is no way they will allow these Satanists to choke the life and the knowledge out of them that God gave them freely through this ministry. Now, an alien invasion. Is it biblical? Of course it is. You might not know this, but after this video, you will have to admit that this is biblical. All right. An alien invasion is biblical. But the problem that we have here is that the words that this generation uses are not necessarily the words that people used in biblical times of old. It's not the language that people used in biblical times of old. It's not the figures of speech that people used in biblical times of old. And Satan, the adversary and the enemy of your soul, knows that. And he wants to use that against you. He wants to use the English language against you. He wants to use history against you. He wants to use knowledge against you. He wants to use the Bible against you. He wants to twist it and use it against you. All right? So anybody out there on YouTube quoting the Bible is not necessarily a Christian brother or sister. YAHUSHUA said in these last days, the very elect will be deceived, if possible. So you better open your eyes, all right? You had better be very careful on YouTube who you friend, who you bless. YAHUSHUA surely said, bless your enemies, okay? But if you want to use it as an excuse to bless Satanists that trample on his blood, use his name and his word to lead others to the pit of hell, then you are wrong. You are deadly wrong if you believe that, all right? But I want to stick to this subject here, all right? Satan knows that the figures of speech and the words that people use in biblical times of old are different than the words that we use. So when God Almighty speaks through his servants, the prophets, like Elizabeth, Elijah, and Nehemiah, about the reality of an upcoming alien invasion, those that can't care less about the truth, and those that are part of the religious folks that claim Jesus is their savior, yet have no clue who he really is, never wanted to pay a price to follow him, never discerned never saw them earnestly to discern his true voice, they will say, well, this must be a false prophet because there is no proof, they say. There's no proof because the words aliens and blue beam are not in the Bible. Well, duh, of course these words are not in the Bible because these scriptures of prophecy were written thousands of years ago, in which people, like I said, use different words, figures of speech, an entire different language. How long does the English language exist as we know it now? And how long does the word alien exist, for example, all right? So, but that doesn't mean that the Bible didn't predict an upcoming alien invasion or false signs and lying wonders like the blue beam rapture that will counterfeit the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. I tell you, those that reject these truths now that they can find in this ministry will one day very soon find out that they are in the middle of that which they mocked and scoffed at right now. Because all these things must come to pass and will come to pass because the Bible prophesied it. And not only that, God Almighty is merciful enough to send his prophets today to warn of the judgment that is to come. And he prophesies it today through his prophets about these things that I just mentioned. All right. Satan and his fallen angels and demons will appear physically on this world's stage one day very soon. All right. They will wreak havoc on this planet. But first they will come with a false peace, all right? So he will appear on this planet, and this is all part of God Almighty's judgment. Okay? Hell will come upon this earth. And this world is already being conformed more and more into the very image of the kingdom of hell. And the question is, will you be ready? Because I tell you, if you stone the holy prophets and messages that God sends forth with this knowledge that he gave in his mercy, that your soul and your life might be preserved, if you stone the prophets, if you do not stick up for them, if you do not rebuke the enemies of God that do know what they are doing. Because I know Yahushua prayed for those that didn't know what they were doing. He said, forgive them, when he was nailed to the cross. All right? But there are also enemies of God that know what they are doing, that have made a pact with the devil to steal as many souls as possible for the kingdom of hell. These people know what they are doing. All right? If you do not defend holy prophets of God against such people, then you are not going to make it. Let me make that clear. If you allow the devil, who goes about like a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour next, to quench the life and the anointing and the knowledge and the wisdom out of you that the servants of God, the prophets, are being sent to give you, you are not going to make it. The question is, will you be ready? Because you will not escape the wrath and judgment that is to come upon this earth. Because the enemies of God, they say, all the hate in the world cannot stop the love of Jesus Christ, they say. But they forget to mention one thing. And that is, that Jesus Christ, YAHUSHUA, is a God of balance. They refuse to mention the wrath of the Lamb, who will come back as the lion of the tribe of Judah with fire in his eyes. He will come back and there will be no mercy for his enemies. He will rip and tear them to shreds. Alright. They will not mention the wrath of the Lamb. But this ministry will warn you for the wrath of the Lamb. You had better repent of your sins. You had better strive for holiness. For without holiness, no man will see heaven. That's what the Bible says. Revelation 12 talks about those that keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of YAHUSHUA. It doesn't talk about those that break the commandments of God. What side are you really on? YAHUSHUA said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Are you keeping his commandments? Are you really on his side? Are you really proving that you love him? Or are you trampling on his blood? YAHUSHUA has told us, he has forewarned us, that all the evil in the world cannot stop his wrath. He has told us, watch ye therefore, pray always that ye might be accounted worthy to escape these things that must and will come to pass one day very soon, and to stand before him, the Son of God, as his bride, without spot and without wrinkle. Will you be ready? What side are you on? Ask yourself this question. So after this video, as we expose our enemies again, you can make a decision where you stand. You're either with us or you are against us. You're either with people that are striving to keep God's commandments, or you are with people like Red Smokey, who has his demons manifesting in the open, who lies, cheats, steals, slanders, lies. You can make the decision where you want to stand. You can stand in darkness or you can stand in light. Now back to the subject here. How can I show you that an alien invasion has in fact already happened in biblical times of old? Now to show you this is very easy, because accounts thereof have been given in the very first book of the Bible, the book of Genesis, chapter 6. But we're going to take a look at this later, because first I want to take you to the definition of the word alien. And of course, in this case, the word alien refers to an extraterrestrial being and not a foreigner. So what is the definition of the word extraterrestrial being? It's a form of life assumed to exist outside the Earth or its atmosphere. So in other words, an alien can be simply any creature unknown that is not of this planet. According to how this generation uses the word alien and the definition that is attached to extraterrestrial being, according to this generation. Now I want to be very careful here, because there are people running around and false prophets that try to teach you that Jesus the Christ is an alien that will come back in a spaceship. Now if you believe that, you better stop believing that for the sake of your soul. Because I tell you, YAHUSHUA, Jesus, is not and never will be an alien. And he surely doesn't need a spaceship to come back, because he rides on the clouds. He's the creator of heaven and earth and the word of God, alright? He is not an unknown creature when he comes back. All knees will bow and tongues confess at him as Lord. All will know who he is when he comes back to set up his millennium kingdom after the great tribulation. All will know that this is truly the Son of God, the Messiah of mankind. Okay, that this is God Almighty. All will see him, all will know him. So you better get that out of your mind right now. So getting that out of the way, let's continue. This world system of iniquity has made sure that when we hear the word alien, we think about these odd-shaped headed creatures, big eyes, skinny bodies that can enter the psyche of human beings. Now, while this all may be true, they can do all that and actually appear as such creatures, this was Satan's purpose, and to use it as a cover-up of his elite troops and fallen angels and demons to manipulate your mind so that you will never even think of the Bible, of the possibility that these are fallen angels. But more about that later. Now, as we keep in mind that an alien is a form of life existing outside the Earth, we can conclude that this includes angels, mainly talking about fallen angels, from other atmospheres, realms, and heavens. Alright? So, aliens visiting or even invading this very planet. It is biblical because accounts thereof have been given in the very first book of the Bible, the book of Genesis chapter 6. Please read with me. And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair. And they took them wives of all which they chose. And YAHUVEH said, My spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh, yet his days shall be 120 years. There were giants in the earth in those days. And also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, the same became mighty men which were of old, men of renown. The sons of God that is spoken of here refers to heavenly angels that chose to rebel against their creator, YAHUVEH. Alright? Whereas they were set to watch over this earth and to serve man, they plotted amongst themselves to betray mankind and to lust after and take the women of this earth. Now, as these fallen angels bred with women, creatures were born that were half human, half angel. These are the hybrids. And these were the giants and mighty men that the Bible spoke of. This means that there were creatures on the earth in those days that were inhuman in appearance and in strength. And it's very interesting, because YAHUSHUA prophesied that as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be again in these last days. It will be actually even worse. And now you have people like Lady Gaga, who is in hybrid herself, okay, preparing this world to deem it normal, okay, that such creatures will be among us, because they will manifest themselves just like they are one day very soon again, like it was in the days of Noah, okay? So for all those watching this, listening to the garbage of Lady Gaga, you are buying into a satanic agenda that is ushering in the new world order. YAHUVEH's judgment was unleashed upon this earth in the days of Noah, and he destroyed all creatures on this earth with a worldwide flood, yet he spared righteous Noah and his family. One of the reasons that he did that is because the hybrids, the giants, were eating up the people on the earth in those days. Okay? They had defiled the human race and bloodline so much that Satan, through these giants and these acts that the fallen angels committed that were breeding with the women of this earth, he tried to destroy the possibility of a savior being born among mankind. All right. So God Almighty destroyed the fallen angel seed so that the savior could eventually be born from a Hebrew virgin who was supernaturally overshadowed by the Holy Spirit and came forth in the flesh. The word of God was made flesh. Now in the book of Enoch, which is a holy book that the Bible itself refers to in the book of Jude chapter 1 verse 14 to 15, which was omitted from the holy scriptures by man with selfish reasons and motivations, as they deemed certain books, holy books like the book of Enoch, too confrontational for man, so they just threw them out. In the book of Enoch, it says something very interesting about the giants, the hybrids, the half human, half angels. But before I continue, I want to say this. Because man has omitted these books, like the book of Enoch, from the Holy Scriptures, it has given many so-called Christians an opportunity and an excuse to call the lost books of the Bible, which they truly don't know anything about, evil, demonic, and garbage, because they were not included in their King James Version. But I tell you this, if you jump on the bandwagon of such people and dare to call these lost books evil without even studying them, you are calling the word of God evil, because the Bible itself refers to those books. So be not deceived. Especially when you watch this video, now you know better. Alright? So, having that out of the way, the book of Enoch, it says something very interesting about the giants. We're going to take a look at the book of Enoch in a moment. YAHUVEH God decided that because the giants had their origin from heavenly creatures, angels that fell, yet were born among mankind on this earth, that their judgment when they died would be a different kind of judgment than the fallen angels that are bound, or human beings that are like suffering the flames of hell at this time, awaiting their final judgment. Because these giants didn't really belong to heaven, neither to earth, yet were born on this earth, when they died, their spirits went forth from their bodies and they became evil spirits that would continue to wander around on this earth, always seeking rest and peace, but finding none, hungering and thirsting, craving to possess a human body so that they can commit the same sinful and abominable and horrendous acts they were used to doing when they were still the giants on this earth in the flesh. All right, this is what the book of Enoch says in chapter 15 verse 8 to 12. And now the giants who are produced from the spirits and flesh shall be called evil spirits upon the earth, and on the earth shall be their dwelling. Evil spirits have proceeded from their bodies, because they are born from men, and from the holy watches is their beginning and primal origin. They shall be evil spirits on earth, and evil spirits, or demons, shall they be called. As for the spirits of heaven, in heaven shall be their dwelling, but as for the spirits of the earth which were born upon the earth shall be their dwelling. And the spirits of the giants afflict, oppress, destroy, attack, and do battle, and work destruction on the earth, and cause trouble. They take no food, but nevertheless hunger and thirst, and cause offenses. And these spirits shall rise up against the children of men, and against the women, because they have proceeded from them. So as you can see, the book of Enoch, that the Holy Bible itself refers to, explains us that the spirits of the giants became demons. And even those same spirits that were destroyed, the giants that were destroyed in the flood in the days of Noah, these same spirits are wandering on this earth even today, causing offenses, wreaking havoc among mankind. And this explains the reality of demonic oppression and possession, as these demons, the spirits of the giants, always seek to attach themselves to human being or to possess human beings. And this is the cause of many things, many sins, addictions, lust, fornication, drunkenness, porn, booze, intoxication of the mind, depression, thoughts of suicide, thoughts of murder, and, you know, the list goes on, okay? These same spirits are also working through the governments of this world. As this written, we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this age. These same spirits work through governmental powers to establish a new world order, to set the stage for the Antichrist to appear. These are, you know, some of the tasks of these demons. Now, every single human being on this earth has at least one or more of those demons assigned against them, to either torment them or entice them until the day they die in their sins and YAHUVEH's judgment is upon them, all right? So these demons' purpose is to keep us away and straying from the path of life that leads to life everlasting, which is YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, the Son of God. Now, everybody in this world, therefore, needs deliverance from something. And I especially am talking about those that have not surrendered their lives to YAHUSHUA, Jesus Christ, yet. Everybody, especially among those people, need deliverance from something, because these demons are tormenting them, are enticing them, causing them to sin, causing them to stumble, causing them to break the commandments of God until the day they die. But thank God, because those that are born again by the Spirit of YAHUSHUA through faith in his name and blood have been given the authority over demonic spirits. In Luke chapter 10 verse 19, YAHUSHUA said, I have given you the power to trample on serpents and scorpions, demons, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. So we have been given, if we obey YAHUSHUA and keep his commandments and are washed in his blood, the power, the same power that he had to destroy the works of the devil. So never ever let anybody tell you, if you are born again and striving to live holy, that you should not rebuke the devil, or that you do not have the authority to rebuke demons and to bind demons. Only Satan would want to take that authority from you, because he knows that you have been given the authority to destroy his works. And I praise God that although these demons are assigned against mankind, those that are truly YAHUSHUA's, whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, they cannot be plucked from YAHUSHUA's or the Heavenly Father's hand, because he will not lose one of his own. But when somebody is saved, the number of demons that is assigned against them by Satan increases, and this explains the trials, the tribulation, the test, the pressure that a child of God goes through, okay? Because these demons are assigned against a child of God to entice them away from the path of life. Remain close to YAHUSHUA's heart. Keep his commandments. So this, and stay washed in his blood. When you accidentally sin, ask forgiveness and turn your back on sin and move further. So this concerning demons, their origin and their purposes. Now, back to the fallen angels that came to this earth to defile themselves amongst women. Are they qualified to be called aliens? Of course. Remember the definition of the word alien: extraterrestrial being, a form of life assumed to exist outside the earth or its atmospheres. Angels are fallen angels who especially masquerade as an entirely unknown creature, are just that. They're aliens to this human race because they are not of this planet. So we can therefore say that alien visitations and invasions have happened somewhere in between creation and Noah's Ark in the book of Genesis chapter 6. So we can therefore say that alien visitations and invasions have happened somewhere in between creation and Noah's Ark in the book of Genesis chapter 6. When the fallen angels came to this earth, that is what you can call an alien invasion. YAHUSHUA, the Son of God, prophesied about these last days that as it was in the days of Noah, so will also the time of his second coming and basically before his second coming be. So keeping that in mind, you know, the prophecies of the last days leading up to the Great Tribulation, which is only a breath away now, are found in the book of Matthew chapter 24. Now, if we know that in these last days it is going to be worse than in the days of Noah, and if we know that the Son of God himself prophesied and has warned this generation that it will be again as in the days of Noah, the same things will happen again. Now, keeping that in mind, does that open up the door to the possibility of another alien invasion as it happened in the book of Genesis chapter 6? Yes, of course it does. For as it was in the days of Noah, so it will be again in these last days. And this automatically eliminates all the accusations of those that have pointed the finger at Prophet Elizabeth Elijah, saying she is a false prophet because of the revelations that God has given her concerning the reality of an upcoming alien invasion. Fallen angels will invade this planet again to wreak havoc, to rob, steal, kill, and destroy, just like their father, the devil, does. So, but let me ask you, what good would it be for the devil and his fallen angels to appear on this world stage and say, well, folks, here we are to wreak havoc just like the Bible predicted. You see, I'm the devil and these are my fallen angels that have messed you up since the very beginning. We know that, of course, Satan will not do that. Because the Bible teaches us clearly that Satan is a master deceiver and master counterfeiter that seeks to copy and counterfeit everything that God Almighty is and everything that God Almighty does. This is all about cover-up. Satan uses the ideas that are attached to the word aliens and that have been planted into our mind by the system of this world and through the deception of entertainment, for example, and the music industry as a cover-up for his fallen angels and demons. For if we believe that these beings are aliens or are higher developed civilization from another planet that will come with good intentions for this earth, we will not even think of the Holy Bible. And we will exclude the possibility that this is Satan and his fallen angels that the Bible warned us about. This is about deception and this is about cover-up, like I said. The Bible tells us that Satan himself can transform himself into an angel of light. And so can his ministers, his troops, do the same thing. And they will transform themselves to deceive the masses of this world. Satan will say, I am Jesus Christ. And his fallen angels will say, we are a different civilization from another planet. And we came to teach you peace. And the masses will believe this nonsense because they are either deceived and want to believe this, or because they are in fear and want to save their lives, or because they have a lack of knowledge. And that is where a ministry like this, a Mighty Word ministry, comes in. To share the knowledge and the prophetic messages and the revelation straight from heaven that YAHUVEH and YAHUSHUA have given to Prophet Elizabeth Elijah, to share with this generation that they will not be deceived. And so that they will not perish for lack of knowledge. And this is the reason why we have so much opposition and enemies and hatred and persecution from all sides, no matter where we go on places like YouTube, by supposed Christians. Because I tell you, Satan has his agents, in place that just as surely as he masquerades himself as an angel of light, masquerade themselves as Christian ministers. And they present to you a watered-down, New Age, carnally-minded Christianity in which you will never put any works behind your faith, never even try to obey Jesus Christ. You would just say, well, he died on the cross and that's enough for me. And these people are putting a sleeper hold on the Christian community, that they will become just like they are, so that when a ministry like this comes in that warns of God's judgment on sin, then we are the haters. And then we are the crazy and the sick people. And this is how they program your mind. And I ask you, as the truth is unfolding in these videos that we make for the sake of you, the love of the people, the love for your soul, what are you doing to help this ministry get the truth out? What are you doing to spread the words of God Almighty for this end time generation? What are you doing to defend the prophet that pays a price to share this knowledge with you so that your life and soul might be preserved? How you treat the prophets of God is how you treat him, is how you treat God himself, because he uses the prophets as his mouthpiece. Now, it's sad to say that this ministry has become like a victim of satanic networks that operate like that, but the Bible did not promise us anything else, okay? The fact that this is happening is a sign that this is a true ministry of God. We are validated by our enemies because this is what the Bible predicted. The book of Matthew chapter 24 sums it all up, what we can expect. The devil counterfeiting the second coming of YAHUSHUA, Jesus, claiming to be Jesus Christ, and the devil claiming to be God, because YAHUSHUA is God, which we can also find this prophecy about the devil claiming to be God in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3 to 4, and we can also see in the book of Matthew chapter 24, as it was in the days of Noah. Like I said, I keep repeating this, it will be again in these last days, which opens up the possibility to another alien invasion. If the prophecies in Matthew chapter 24 are not convincing enough for you concerning the possibility of an alien invasion, let me remind you of the book of Revelation and chapter 9 about the horrific creatures that will walk the face of this earth during the Great Tribulation. And this is especially for all those that are not only mocking this ministry concerning the revelations about the aliens, but about the zombies. Let's read together in the book of Revelation chapter 9. And the shapes of the locusts were like unto horses prepared unto battle, and on their heads were as it were crowns like gold, and their faces were as the faces of men. And they had hair as the hair of women, and their teeth were as the teeth of lions. And they had breastplates, as it were breastplates of iron, and the sound of their wings was as the sound of chariots of many horses running to battle. And they had tails like unto scorpions, and there were stings in their tails, and their power was to hurt men 5 months. And they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue had this name Apollyon. Now, have you ever heard of such creatures or seen such creatures, even in horror movies? I don't think so. And I tell you this. That which this generation is used to seeing in horror and science fiction movies is nothing compared to what is going to happen and what is going to be seen on this earth. And soon all this will become reality. So all those that mock the possibility of aliens and zombies through which Satan counterfeits the resurrection of the dead, you are mocking the Holy Bible. If you cannot believe these things, then how in the world can you believe the book of Revelation? Let me ask you that. It's not possible. But Matthew chapter 24, verse 4, let's read again. For there shall arise false Christ and false prophets, and shall shew great signs and wonders, insomuch that, if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 8 to 12, and then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, God shall send them strong delusion that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness. Are you receiving the love of the truth that YAHUSHUA is presenting to you in this ministry? Because if you do not receive it and purposely mock it and align yourself with fake Christians, God will send, and behold, He is already doing it, send a strong delusion upon you that you will believe a lie. Do you want to believe a lie? Do you want to be damned? If not, then stop mocking what you don't understand. Stop mocking the Bible. Stop mocking the Word of God. Stop mocking His prophets. Defend His prophets and repent. Because I tell you again and again, the cloak is removed from the enemy. Lies are being exposed and the truth is prevailing because good always prevails. The Bible is clear. The devil will work with power, false signs, and lying wonders. And the Bible teaches us clearly that he seeks to copy, imitate, and counterfeit everything that God Almighty does. Because he has said in his heart, I will be like the Most High. If YAHUSHUA predicted that the second coming will be seen by all in the sky, and that just as he was taken up by a cloud after his resurrection, he would come back in the same manner, seen by all in the glory of his Father in the sky, doesn't it make sense that the devil, with his sick desire to be like the Most High, seeks to counterfeit even that? And that is, my friend, where Project Blue Beam comes in. In the book of Daniel, we have been taught in chapter 12, verse 4, it says, But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. Now is that time. Knowledge has increased that was not available in those biblical times of old. And I'm not saying that humanity back then was not as wise as we are, or we're not advanced yet as we are. But there are some things that this generation knows that they didn't know yet. And for example, Blue Beam Project. Satellite and laser techniques that Satan has shared with humanity straight from the pit of hell for the sake of imitating the second coming of YAHUSHUA, the true Christ, announcing in the sky the arrival of the Antichrist claiming to be Jesus Christ. Like I said, imitating the second coming of YAHUSHUA, HaMashiach. Now again, the doors that Bible prophecy opens to the reality and the possibility of false signs and lying wonders taking place, such as Project Blue Beam, automatically eliminates the false reasoning of those that dare to point a finger at Elizabeth saying she prophesies falsely. And who are they? Those that do not even study to show themselves approved because they have no fear of God. Who are they to call Elizabeth Elijah a false prophet? Because I tell you, those that mock these prophecies and have trouble believing what is contained within these prophecies concerning the subjects that are spoken of in this video, they prove of what little faith they are, because they cannot possibly believe the book of Revelation, for example, chapter 9. Those that refuse to study and show themselves approved, that do not even know what they are talking about. Those that call the lost books of the Bible satanic and evil, while the Bible itself refers to those books, thus calling the Word of God itself satanic and evil. And those people are calling Prophet Elizabeth Elijah a false prophet. Foolish pride and no discernment. Satan has blinded their minds and hearts, and then they dare to say, Jesus is my Savior. You know, these hypocrites that do this, they are willingly ignorant, and they want to be deceived, or are either part of Satan's evil agenda to usher in a new world order. Because it is stupidity and it is foolishness to say to the one that loves you enough to warn you, that pays a price to warn you, that takes the persecution and the hatred from all sides to get the message from heaven to you, given by God Almighty, that might preserve your soul in these last days, to say to that person, well, you are a false prophet in my opinion, because you see, I open up my Bible and it never refers to the words alien and blue beam. And again I say, well, duh, the Bible doesn't mention the word microwave either. That doesn't make him not real. Foolishness and pride. And all you that do this had better repent, because your souls are at stake. And the hypocrites that do this, I am more than convinced that they are too busy engaging in the sins that this world has to offer and saturating themselves with the lusts that this world has to offer to even care about the truth. And all these things that will come to pass and that come upon this earth one day very soon. Because I tell you, it takes an ignoramus to not see that the Bible, specifically the prophecies in the book of Revelation, are coming to pass before our very eyes each and every day, line upon line, precept upon precept, precept upon precept. Now what does that mean? It means that the world as we know it is rapidly changing before our very eyes and coming to an end. And all those that refuse to jump aboard the only ark of safety, YAHUSHUA, the Son of God, those that reject him as Savior, those that throw his own blood back into his own face, you are coming to an end altogether with this world. And I tell you, it is not worth it. It is not worth it to close your eyes and to close your ears, to shut your ears and stick your head in the sand, being willingly ignorant, teaching others to do the same, while keep on playing your Xboxes, saturating your mind with the filth that this world system has to offer until you are in a state of spiritual imbecility and not ready, not praying always to be accounted worthy to escape these things, not seeking God's face earnestly. And sad to say, this is that broad way, that wide gate. And many, most, will go into that gate. Sad to say. But those that are watching, it is no coincidence that God Almighty, by the power of His Spirit, has drawn you to hear these truths. Because He doesn't want you to perish. He wants that all should come to repentance. It is not worth it. Your soul is at stake at this time, and the clock is ticking. The great tribulation is a breath away. God's wrath is about to be poured out upon this earth. Will you be ready? There are not a lot of ministries that will talk about this. A Mighty Wit ministry does. That's why we are being persecuted and hated, especially by many of those that call themselves Christians, yet have no clue who Jesus Christ is. This whole thing is about seeking YAHUVEH God earnestly. Your only hope is seeking YAHUVEH God earnestly today through His Son, YAHUSHUA, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, who spit and shed His blood for you on a wooden cross of Calvary, so that in Him you might obtain forgiveness of sin, a reconciliation with Himself and the Heavenly Father. This is your only blessed hope for the salvation of your soul and to escape these things that will come upon this earth that we spoke about in this video. The only hope is falling on your knees, flat on your faces today, repenting wholeheartedly of your sins, being willing to turn away from your sins, and allowing YAHUVEH and YAHUSHUA to fill you with their precious Holy Spirit, who enables you to walk in a loving and obedient relationship with God Almighty, in which you keep His commandments. Not break them, but keep them. Because 1 John tells us, if we say we know YAHUSHUA, but do not keep His commandments, we are found liars and the truth is not even in us. We ought to walk like YAHUSHUA Himself walked. That doesn't mean we are God or we can become gods, never. But it means that we establish and keep the commandments like YAHUSHUA our Master did and asked us to do so, because He said, if you love me, keep my commandments. And this is only possible through the power of the Holy Spirit. And with that comes the holy gift of discernment, interpretation, and truthful reasoning, so you can interpret divine wisdom that is contained within the Holy Scriptures and contained within the holy prophecies that the same Holy Spirit inspired, that are found in a Mighty Wind ministry, amightywind.com. Without these gifts of the Holy Spirit, and without the Holy Spirit, and anybody, whether it are scholars or experts or whoever, that says different is a liar. You need the Holy Spirit to interpret divine wisdom like God meant it to be interpreted, like God meant it to be taught. No one will enter heaven through any other door than YAHUSHUA our Mashiach, our blessed hope and only ark of safety and only hope for forgiveness of sin. If you, the viewer, no matter who you are, no matter where you are, God is everywhere and sees everything. If you have not surrendered your heart and mind yet to the Son of God, YAHUSHUA HaMashiach, who created you, then I encourage you and I pray earnestly that you will do so today, yea, right now. Get into that only ark of safety because time is running out. Repent of your sins. At the end of this video, I will put a link to the salvation prayer. And after that, read Prophecy 115 that is found on amightywind.com, which testifies and prophesies of the reality of a totalitarian dictatorship that is to come upon the upon America and the entire world, a new world order. It is going to be a rough ride, and it's right now time to get wise and get right with your Creator. So